Hello friends, this is our second lecture one of Youth and Age. Last one we had an introduction. Today we begin with the first sentence. A man that is young may be old in hours if he has lost no time. There are some very regular and steady persons. They don't lose even a single year in their academic life or after they join a company or for a job. They continue, they are very regular people. Such people, he says, they are mature. Old here means they are mature even when they are very young. But there are some others, no? They are dropouts or they are rolling stone, right? Jump from one job to another and so on. That will be wasting their time, wasting their hours, wasting their days. Such people, you cannot say they are matured in their youth. Second sentence is, but that happens rare. It's a very rare situation. Even you can see big guns, they discontinued their studies, then afterwards they join. After say 5 years, 6 years and so on. So such people you cannot say, they are very rare people, regular and steady. Generally, youth is like the first cogitation, not so wise as the second. Definition of youth. Youth is like the first thought, not like the second one. Usually the second one is wiser than the first one. Example, you see a snake. First thought is take a stick and kill it, beat and kill it. Second thought you will think, it is a beautiful creature, why should I kill it? It is just like me, it has got also the right to live. So you will say, make some sound and then it will disappear. That is second thought and that is wiser. Why should we kill something? It is also doing some good to us. Sometimes you may not agree with me, it doesn't matter. At this stage it doesn't matter. Okay, and then fourth sentence is, for there is a youth in thoughts as well as ages. There is a youth in thoughts, means some thoughts, that means they are very quick. They are a quick action. That is thought in youth, means. There is a youth in thought, means quick thoughts. They are young thoughts. And second thoughts, they are mature thoughts. Ages here means mature. The first thought may not be mature, but the second thought will be mature. Just now, as I told you. Or suppose you find our normal attitude towards dogs is when you see dog, you take a stone and throw. That is the quick thought, means youth in thoughts. But the ages in thought will be, why should we do like this? It is a good animal. It is very faithful to humans, useful to humans and so on, I think. That is youth in the thought in ages. Youth in thought means the first thoughts, the quick thought that comes to your mind. And then the second one is slow. Means you think it out. That is ages means mature. And yet, the introduction of young men is more lively than that of old. And imagination stream into their minds better. And as it were more divine. So you say that young men, their intervention is to be appreciated. But they have two good qualities. One is they're quick to imagine things than the old people. Secondly, imagination comes streaming into their mind. It's one after another. New thoughts, imagination here, new thoughts. New thoughts come first to young people. And then they come one after another. But the old people, it's not like that. Because new thoughts are very difficult. Secondly, if a new thought comes, it comes very slowly. That's the thing. And yet, intervention of young men. Intervention means opinion. Intervention in opinion of young men is more lively than that of old. And imagination stream into their minds better and as it was, no, more divinely. As you think that imaginations, they come divinely, with some divine inspiration. Divinely means with divine inspiration. So, to give an example, suppose there is a problem, you have to solve a problem. you give that problem to old men and also young men. Young men will come back with quick decisions, quick solutions. Old men will come, sit there, see the pros and cons and so on. And then only they will come to a conclusion. That is it. It divinely comes means one after another comes, as if it is inspired by God. Natures that have much heat and great and violent desires and perturbations are not ripe for action till they have passed the meridian of their years, as it was with Julius Caesar and Septimus Severus. So there are some people who up to the age of 40, they lead a kind, they are violent. their nature is violent. Much heat, short-tempered. They are short-tempered, they are violent, and their desires and perturbation, disturbed mind. Perturbations, their mind disturbed. So such people, they are not ripe for action. They are not ready for action. Means balanced action till they reach the meridian of their life or years, means middle age. That was the case with the Julius Caesar and Septimus Severus. Julius Caesar and Septimus Severus, they were great emperors. And the second one, the latter one, that is the Septimus Severus, was greatest of all. But both of them in their younger days, they were very violent, they were short-tempered, and they were of disturbed mind. So if you are short-tempered, disturbed mind and violent, what will happen? You will harm others. You will create problems for others. So they were like that. But after their 40s, they settled down, became great emperors. And about the latter, Septimus Severus, it is said, Juventutam edit erroribus imma furoribus plena. That is Latin. Latin is very often many times I told you this phonetic language means written and read in the same way. English is unphonetic. So if you say like that, Juventutam edit erroribus, error, full of error, and furoribus. Furoribus means disturbance, madness. He the Juventutam means youth. Youth was full of errors and furoribus, that is fury, that is madness. Plena means full. Plena. Plenum in English, no? There is a word in English, no? Plenum. The plenum of the assembly, the full assembly. There are 100 members, all the 100 members are present. Plenum. So plena. Furor. Fury. Fury is madness. Error equals error. Edit. Juventutu. Imma means ne, not really. So the translation is he passed a youth full of errors more than that of madness. Errors and madness. Who? Septimus Severus. But about whom? Bacon says, and yet he was the ablest emperor almost of all the list. In his youth he was full of madness, furoribus and erroribus. But after his youthful years, say 40s also, he became emperor and he was the best of the list, even greater than Julius Caesar. But riposte natures may do well in youth. Riposte means balanced. But balanced papers, these are not balanced people. They are violent, they are quick-tempered, they are short-tempered, they will beat anybody and everybody, kill anybody. See that madness, mad people. You can see, no? On the campus, you can see, if you look around, there are some such people. But later in their life, when you meet them, they have, oh, he is the prime minister, or he is a minister, or he is an ambassador, and they will say like that. So that things can happen. But riposte natures means balanced mind. People with balanced mind, he says, but riposte natures may do well in youth. If you have got a balanced mind, you can be very good even when you are young. Example, as it is, we can see as it is, you will find signed in Augustus Caesar. As it is seen in Augustus Caesar, Csmus, Duke of Florence, and And you will find Gaston de Foix of France and others. So these three people, he said, they are balanced people. And they were young. So Augustus Caesar, he took the reins of Rome at the age of 18. Because he was a man of balanced people. And Florence, Csmus, Duke of Florence, he became the governor of Florence. Young man. And Gaston de Foix, he was a French general. And he was young. So that is about it. You find violent people, they become repressed after 40. But there are young people who by nature are repressed. And there are such people like Augustus Caesar and so on. So today we have seen the main point is, a man, if you don't waste your time, you can become mature even when you are young. But this happens very rarely. Generally, youth is like the first thought. Second thought is like that of mature, that is ages. There is a youth in thought and ages. That means first thing, thoughts are youth, of can be compared to young men, and second thoughts can be compared to old men, mature. And that even then, the intervention of young people, they have got wonderful imagination. They come streaming to their mind one after another, as if divinely inspired. But old men are not like that. Nazius, then he speaks about some people who are violent, who are perturbed, who are disturbed, who are short-tempered. They become great after 40s. That example is Julius Caesar and Septimus Severus. Septimus Severus was madman when he was young. But later he became one of the greatest of emperors. And you find people who are balanced in their youth, they become great very early. And they can take up positions of responsibility like Augustus Caesar, or you have got Csmus, Duke of Florence, and also Gaston de Foix of France. I think clear to you fine. Thank you very much for listening, enjoying my classes. But before that, let's wash our hands and flush out Corona. This is this week's slogan for us. This week for you. Last week we had break the chain and crush Corona. Hope that you are following these things fine. Thank you for listening once again. See you again with more enthusiasm and also energy. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.